So one thing that I wanted to show you is not necessarily the correct way to hold a angle grinder, but it's just a technique that I've used since I first picked one up. You want to try to use the same angle grinder, but if you take a triangle or a square and hold your cutoff disc right up against it, put your hand into position, and always pick up your angle grinder in that position. So when your body is, your hand, your wrist is all in a relaxed position, you know that when you're cutting anything, your angle grinder is going to be in that squared position, that natural feeling position every time that you use it.
I don't know of an easy way to explain this, but you pretty much want to maintain a moderate amount of pressure while grinding away all but a 16th of an inch of the jump material. You'll notice that I occasionally lift up on the grinder so that I can check to see how much farther I have to grind to maintain that 16th of an inch. From here I use a much lighter applied downward force in a constantly moving motion with longer strokes. Pay attention to either side of the material being removed. If you're grinding one side and not the other, just change the angle of your grinder so you know you're grinding flat. And if you listen to the sound of your grinder, you'll know if you're overexerting your tool. As with anything, let the tool do the work, and your grinding disc will last that much longer.